Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a topic, a tutorial on equity value. So, you can see a graph over here, and what we notice over here that we are comparing market cap of three companies, Xeon, Apple and Amazon. So, let's have a look at this graph of equity market value of Xeon, Apple and Amazon, and we note that in 2007 and 2008, Xeon was far ahead in terms of the equity value. It's quite visible compared to the Amazon and Apple. However, over the years you can see the market value of the equity has increased, and now they are leading companies. Basically, you can say that over the years Apple and Amazon's market value of the equity has significantly increased, and now they are leading companies by equity market value. So does equity value even matter? That's the question over here. You can see the Xeon over here and this two graph, look at this, of Apple, and same with the Amazon. Even Amazon started growing. So why this thing? Is it equity? What significance does equity value play? No issues, let's deal with this. Equity value. Now, equity value is basically what? Let's write equity value. No, this will, it is enterprise value, EV. Equity value is basically your summation or the sum total of the value of the shareholders have made available for the business. So equity value is also called as your market cap. Right, and can be calculated by multiplying the market value per share, which is your price, into your number of shares, that is P into N. So equity market value is very important for a business owner, especially when he plans out to sell the business, or sells his business. Equity market value gives a good measure of what a seller of a business would receive after the debt has been paid. So let's have a look at some formulas of equity value formula. So equity value formula 1, market value of equity. I'll start with market value of equity is going to be is equal to share price into number of outstanding shares. This is the first formula. Now over here, the share price is the last traded price of the stock, and the number of shares outstanding should be at the latest figures available. Now there is another formula for this equity value formula. The second equity market value formula is commonly used to find the fair equity value using DCF approach. Now there is a thing called enterprise value and equity value. So enterprise value, basically, I'll discuss over here. Enterprise value, EV at the very beginning, is basically total assets, and there are many other things that are involved, and your it involves your liability, shareholders equity, net debt and equity value. So your equity value in this particular scenario is going to be equity value is equal to enterprise value minus the net debt, which is your next formula. Equity value is going to be your enterprise value, EV, minus your net debt. So we use the steps to calculate the fair equity market value. Now the first step goes something like this. Use a DCF approach, a DCF using FCFF, that is a free cash flow to the firm. DCF will provide us the fair valuation of the total firm's enterprise value. The next step is use the formula of the enterprise value, calculating using the DCF. We have to calculate over here EV. So that is fair value the plus fair value plus preferred shares plus minority interest. You need to add any outstanding debt and then deduct any cash and bank balance. That will give you your enterprise value. Then third, we can finally calculate the fair equity value, which is equal to enterprise value, that is your EV, okay, less any preferred shares, less any minority interest, less any outstanding debt, and you will add back any cash and any bank balance. Okay, so this is how it is. We find the fair equity value. The target price of the stock is going to be fair equity value, which we found over here, divided by the number of outstanding shares. Now, you need to note that something, that market price of the stock and the target price of the stock are two different things. One is called market price, another is called target price. They are two different things. Let's assume that market price of, let's say, Apple is $110 per share. Using DCF, you may get a target price of Apple close enough to, let's say, $135. This means that Apple is basically undervalued. This means, you know, it hasn't reached the price of $135. So one should take a buy position in this. Now, let's get to the next level, equity market interpretation. Equity market value is more useful to the seller of a business than an investor. Let's have a detailed look at this. Let's say there is a guy called Mr. A, okay, and he has a company which he wants to sell. So Mr. A is a seller. Now he is concerned about the valuation of the company. One day, while searching for the buyers of his business, Mr. A got a proposal from Mr. B, and Mr. B said he would buy Mr. A's business at certain valuation. Mr. A mentioned that he has taken some loan for his business, which has not been fully paid yet, and Mr. B said that then he would pay the same as the valuation he has calculated. However, there's this Mr. A is saying that he will only receive the money after payment of the debt, and that's market value of equity in the actual sense. Let's understand this in numbers. Let's say Mr. B say that he would pay 10 million for Mr. A's business before knowing that Mr. A has still to pay some debt. And Mr. A mentioned that outstanding debt is, let's say 2 million. So Mr. B agreed to pay Mr. A 10 million for the business, but that would be inclusive of the outstanding debt basically. That means Mr. A would only get how much? It's going to be 10 minus 2, 8. Here the US $10 million is the enterprise value and 8 million is the equity market value. So let's do a final basic example on this and we'll conclude on this. Let us do a basic value example of comparing two companies on the basic equity market value and finding the larger one. Let's say there are two companies, there's company A, there's company B, there are some shares they have and the market price. Let's say there are 30,000 shares over here and 50,000 shares over here. The market price is, let's say over here 100 and over here 90. So in this case, we have given both the numbers of outstanding shares and the market price of the shares. Let's calculate the equity market value of the company A and company B. So the equity market value of the company is going to be as simple as that. Shares into the market price, control R, and there we go. We have our answer, 3,04,50. Right? So basically what we note that the market value of the equity of company A is basically more than company B. But let's tweak few things and calculate enterprise value and let's see, you know, how it turns out to the investor. So based on this, we can make some final conclusion. In the final analysis, it can be said that equity market value is the best method if an owner of a business wants to know how much he would get by selling his business. From investor point of view, enterprise value will fit the bill.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.